Hi, I'm Ashley from Bishop Vesey's in St Coldfield, and I'm volunteering here throughout the summer. This may look like your bog standard piece of sandstone, but as you can see, it's flexible. It was found in Jhajjar in India near Delhi, and has been lying here in the stores for a very long time. The flexibility of these sandstones has puzzled geologists for many years and led to much discussion about why it's so wobbly. Flexible sandstone was first discovered in a small area of Mara Itacolumi in Brazil in 1822. It was thought to be a new type of rock, gaining it the name Itacolumite. Unfortunately, it wasn't a new rock, and it was actually a sandstone formed by the decomposition of gneisses, which contained feldspar grains. This sediment accumulated together just like any old sandstone, but the feldspar grains continued to decompose. This would have left lots of empty spaces within the rock, leaving it a lump of loosely interlocking grains of quartz. Where the quartz grains interlink with their neighbours, quartz crystals have grown, creating joints. These are like your elbow or your knee and allow the rock to manoeuvre like a wobble board. But in case you were wondering, the whole cliff or bed where this was lying wasn't all wobbly. It's only flexible when you cut it into thin sheets like this. Placey minerals such as micas are sometimes found in these sandstones, but they don't affect the flexibility. In some cases, these sandstones are found to lose their flexibility as they dry out, so you better make the most of it while it's still limber.